It's true, it's true, it's true in Europe.
2009.
Une légère envie de violence quand elle relâche ses bas. Je ne suis plus à vendre ou je ne suis plus comme ça. De rumeurs adolescentes disent que je ne suis pas à toi et je pense qu'une part de vrai se cache. Dis-moi si je...
Well, this is the first day this week that it's been sunny. It's been raining all week, so I decided to do something that I hadn't done in a while, and that was go for a walk exploring the city. So I decided to go for a very historically Paris walk. So we're gonna walk from Concord Square up to the Arc de Triomphe and check that out. Situated halfway between the Louvre Museum and the Arc de Triomphe is Place de la Concorde, or Concord Square. Now, Concord Square is 21 acres of fountains, people, crazy traffic, and of course, the obelisk of Luxor. Now, this obelisk is from Egypt. It's over 3,300 years old, and it took 2 years to get here. But it's sent as a thank you because I think some French guy decrypted the hieroglyphics there on it, and so as a thank you for kind of breaking the code, the Egyptian government sent the obelisk here to France to rest here in the square. Now, the square isn't famous for the obelisk. During the French Revolution, this square was where they held all the public executions. Louis XVI, Marie Antoinette, and about 3,000 other people were killed right here in the square with the guillotine. And so this whole area is just steeped with history.
Ça dérange et tu m'attaches les bras quand je fais sautiller sa franche écrit.
The stretch of road leading from Concord Square to the Arc de Triomphe is called Champs-Élysées. It's a 2 kilometer stretch of road which has been here for a very long time. Back in 1667, Louis XIV started the first stretch of it, going from the gardens at where now the Louvre is to Concord Square. But since then, it's just been growing. From the 1920s to 1960s, this whole area, this whole boulevard, was considered just the epitome of Parisian elegance. And locals would even dress up just to take a stroll here, and people definitely, this is definitely where you take your carriages, all that kind of stuff. Since then, it's become a little more commercial. This is where a lot of the big corporations are. They got big shopping centers, the theaters here, the Disney store, all of it's here now, but it still has retained its stereotypical Parisian charm. Built during the first part of the 18th century, the Arc de Triomphe was completed in 1840 to mark the posthumous return of Napoleon to Paris. It was first built to honor Napoleon's forces and their amazing victory at the Battle of Austerlitz, and it's since been dedicated to the glory of all France's armies. And underneath the arches is the Tomb of the Unknown French Soldier, where there's constant burning flame at all times. It's surrounded by a huge, busy thoroughfare roundabout, so you can't actually get to it by crossing the square. You have to walk underground just to get to it to see. But if you climb to the top, you can see the 12 different boulevards pointing off in all the different directions that kind of lead out to different parts of Paris, and one of the best views of Paris, I've been told.
Quand tu ne m'appartiens pas.